In the United Kingdom of Great Britain, EuroProLife has organised another peaceful public prayer procession in the heart of London. These events have two main purposes. The primary purpose is to pray for unborn babies and their parents who are victims of abortion, the politicians that have made it legal, the doctors and nursing staff that perform the killings, and all those who support them and the new right to destroy innocent human life. Over 100 people of all ages gathered, and the procession started with white crosses from Westminster Cathedral just as the rain stopped. The second purpose is to bring all those together who recognise that life is sacred and an eternal gift from the Father. EuroProLife invites all European pro-life organisations and faiths to gather in a public space to pray to the one God that He may be merciful on those who desire to take these innocent lives, for they truly do not know what they are doing. The procession sang the Divine Mercy Chaplet and prayed down Victoria Street.
For the sake of His sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and on the whole world.
And crossing Lambeth Bridge, they turned in front of Lambeth Palace, walked eastward, and arriving at Westminster Bridge, they stopped and held a short ceremony. At 3 o'clock, a historical profound hour, when the greatest triumph of darkness was visited on creation, they tolled the bell, echoing Big Ben.
Belinda!
And the lives lost. Indeed,
Rupert.
They called the names of babies unborn,
Patrick.
Who were lost to abortion. A rose is dropped
Susan.
Into the river to sail mournfully past the Palace of Westminster. Falling to their knees, they finished praying for the babies and their parents in a mournful silence. Rising, they proceed to Parliament Square, and from this island, they, symbolizing a small army, face that great castle built to embody justice, truth, and freedom. Again, they sink to the ground, imploring God to look upon the leaders of Great Britain and be merciful on them, and the doctors and support staff and supporters of the killing. As the grey sky begins to succumb to the dusk, they finish their procession and retreat to an enclosed forecourt of Westminster Abbey. As they gather around the plaque laid in the ground in remembrance of the fallen innocent of war, oppression and violence, and all three apply to the unborn, they individually place white and red roses in a vase as a symbol of remembrance and love.